I have a second floor. I have two School for the Arts, we've had concerts again for the first time in a year and a half, and it's been a bit of a celebration, and we're so glad you're here that we can share our music with you. This is a concert that's been a couple of years in the making, right? A couple of times we thought we were ready to get a concert, and the world changed, and there were no concerts with audiences. So we're so excited that you're here to join us for this. I'm very excited and honored to be here with these gentlemen. These gentlemen are a bit of the who's who in the world of saxophone, from the Dorseys to the Leonard Bernsteins to Zubin Mehta's, New York Philharmonics, LA Philharmonics, you name it. These folks have played with them, and I'm very honored to share the stage with them, and I think you're going to be very excited and enjoy the music we have to play for you today. So thank you so much for joining us for our concert.
I just wanted to add a few words about the history of the Los Angeles Saxophone Quartet. I first actually registered the name of the Los Angeles Saxophone Quartet on August 10th, 1970. We were together for a few years. That is Roger Greenberg, myself, and the Teochioka, the composer of the next piece, played baritone saxophone. Victor Morasco played in the group. And he made a CD of the Art of Fugue by J.S. Bach. It's still available. Coming back to the Los Angeles Saxophone Quartet, of course, is a great pleasure. Roger and I are glad to be back to it. We're honored to be joined together by Jeff Benedict and Charlie Richard, phenomenal musicians, and Emmett has now, over these years, written many pieces for the saxophone, to include aria and allegro for saxophone quartet, dual concertino for saxophone concert band, intermezzo for soprano saxophone band, and many others. So Emmett is really a composer, a master musician. He lives in Honolulu. He wanted to come today, but is working himself. He is a working musician. And he's been a great friend for many years. I met Emmett Yoshioka in 1960 at a dinner for freshmen at the University of Southern California, dinner for freshman music majors. And he looked at me, we were sitting next to one another. He said, "Where are you from?" I said, "I live in Los Angeles here." I said to him, "Where are you from?" He said, "Well, I'm from Hawaii. I live in Honolulu." And I looked at him without thinking and said, this was 1970 now. I looked at him and said, "Well, how do you like the United States?" And he looked at me. He looked at me like this. And he said, "You mean the mainland?" And that was the beginning of a more than 50-year, 60-year friendship. We were, Roger and Emmett and I were in the West Point band together in the 60s during the Vietnam era, etc., in college together. So this does go back, and it's a thrill for me to be a part of this Los Angeles Saxophone Quartet once again. I should add that since there are no real notes on this Yoshioka quartet, the second and third movements are played without pause.
Thank you. Italian composer Alberto Ginastera wrote his American preludes in a variety of styles. Originally for piano, the movements are very short, with some in a nationalistic style, some with no references to style, and some using the pentatonic scale that Ginastera associated with the original Inca inhabitants of South America. This is Alberto Ginastera's American Prelude.
King Bozza was an extremely prolific composer of music for solo, wind instruments, or chamber groups. Anybody who has played any musical instrument has probably played a piece by Eugene Bozza. The Andante and Scherzo was written in 1938. The Andante is just as it sounds. It's a beautiful flowing melody that gets passed around between the voices with beautiful and varied accompaniment. The Scherzo is supposed to be a little bit crazy, a little very fast. The Scherzo was an outgrowth of the minuet when classical composers, starting with Beethoven, got tired of running minuets. They wanted to get that third movement over with quicker than just about to write something fast and crazy to get over. So this is Eugene Bozza's Andante and Scherzo.
using elements of jazz and classical music in his tango compositions. He became a very controversial person in Argentina. There were many people who condemned him for changing the traditional tango, while others championed him for creating what later became known as Nuevo Tango. Today, he is held in high regard not only in Argentina, but worldwide. There are three tangos by Astor Piazzolla.
Thank you.
I would be remiss if I didn't thank Professor Kevin Mays and Professor Charles Richard for making it possible. Kevin, is that you right there? Where's Kevin? Kevin. Anyway, Professor Kevin Mays, Professor Charles Richard, who work here at RCC, they have made it possible for us to rehearse and perform in this beautiful hall. So we thank you, Charlie.
People should know better than let me hear a microphone. I arranged this last piece we're going to play. It's by a Mexican composer, Mr. Ponce, and he's sort of the Chopin of Mexico. This was a little piano piece that was very popular, the Scherzino Mexicano.